Now in section 2.24, we will discuss the curl of E, that what will be the curl or the twisting of E. Keep in mind one thing, that we are in electrostatics, and as we have already discussed, that for the electrostatics, the electric field lines are never curling. The electric field lines from a point charge are always diverging from it and they are not curling. Now for that situation, when the electric field lines, let me consider a charge here, and this is a charge and the electric field lines are going away from it. This is a geometrical representation, so we will draw a few lines here, although the lines are almost infinite. There are as many lines we can draw, but this is a geometrical representation, and with few lines we show that the electric field lines are diverging from the point charge, and in this situation the electric field is equal. If this is a charge Q, then the electric field is equal to 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R square and in R unit vector direction. This is, in this notation, it means that the point charge is at the origin, and that's why instead of the tilted R, we are using like this. Now, if I consider another figure, and the figure is this one, mean like for a source charge, when it is a point charge, the electric field lines are in a diverging manner and they are not curving, and that's why I will say for these lines that the electric field is not curling. The electric field curl is equal to zero. They are not curling. So another figure that we are going to draw here is this one. That, let's say, this is the x, y and z axis here. This is a three-dimensional situation, x and y and z here, and now we are putting the charge here. This is the source charge, which is here, a positive source charge, and we are at this point, let's say this is point A, and the distance from here to here is, let's say, RA. And in the field of this charge, we are calculating the line integral on this electric field. And let's say we are reaching point B here. And point B from the origin is at RB distance. So while reaching from here to here, let's say we follow this path. And we calculate the line integral on this path. So what will be the line integral here? And this is E dot. This is a line integral. And we are going from point A to point B. And this is E dot dl. We know that in three-dimensional or in spherical polar coordinates, we were having the dl is equal to dr in r unit vector plus r d theta in theta unit vector and plus r sine theta r sine theta d phi and phi unit vector. So is our electric field here is an r unit vector direction. It is radially outward here. We can draw the same electric field lines here for this situation. So I will write that E dot dl will be equal, I can write here that E dot dl for all others, for theta and for phi, as it is a dot product and they are perpendicular to each other, so they will go to zero. And we are left only with this, that this is 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught and q over r square. R unit vector with r unit vector become 1, and this is dr. And now I will integrate both sides. So this is integration from a to b, and here this will also be integrated from a to b. And this is equal to q is constant, so q over 4 pi epsilon naught here, and integral from a to b, and 1 over r square dr. And we know that the derivative of minus 1 over r is 1 over r square. So we have minus q over 4 pi epsilon naught, and this will be 1 over r. The minus is already we have written here, and the limits are from a to b here. So this is equal to integral from a to b, and E dot dl is equal to, if I write this one, is q over 4 pi epsilon naught here. This is 1 over r b minus 1 over r a, but multiplying with this minus, we will reverse them. So this is equal to 1 over r a minus 1 over r b here. And now our electric field is equal to this one. The line integral is equal to this one. We move in this field, which is due to this source charge q, and we reach from a to b here. Now whatever way I start from b and come back along this path or any other path and reach here, because the integral is taking the endpoints, then what will be the situation when I will take a closed loop integral? This is open loop, one side. Closed loop, I am returning to that point in E dot dl, and this is equal to, for a closed path, the Ra is equal to Rb, means I will return to the Ra again, and this means that Ra for a closed path will be equal to Rb. They are now the same points, and that's why they will cancel then. And we will have the closed path integral here equal to zero. Basically, I will tell you some interpretation behind this one. But first, let me complete this situation. And here, I can now apply the Stokes theorem. Now, as we know, that the Stokes theorem says that if we take a surface integral, and we take the curl of any physical quantity, a vector quantity, dot dA means is the flux of the curl of that quantity, then it is the same that if you take a closed path integral and you take the quantity directly and makes its dot product with the length element. So this side is exactly the same as this side. So from here, I can write that E dot dl is equal from here, E dot dl is equal from here to integral on a surface del cross E dot dA, and this is equal to zero. This implies that del cross E is equal to zero, means the curl of electric field is equal to zero, and this is something which we were behind to prove, that the curl is equal to zero. Now let's start here. Del cross E is equal to zero. We know that what is E? E is the force on a unit charge. So I can write that this implies that del cross F over Q is equal to zero. And this implies that del cross F is equal to zero. So the curl of the field is equal to zero. Then the curl of the force which is associated with that field is also equal to zero. And such a field is called a conservative field. Such a force is called a conservative force. And when in integral form, a field is conservative if its closed loop integral is equal to zero. Such field we call is conservative field. We say that it is E dot dl is independent of the path. It only depends on the first and the last, or the starting and the end point. Such field we call is conservative fields. Now what is basically this thing? E dot dl. This is basically the work done on a unit charge, because this is E is from here equal to force per unit charge dot dl, and this is equal to 1 over Q F dot dl. And what is F dot dl? F dot dl is the work done dw, and as it is integral, so this is integral and Q, and this is equal to the work done on a unit charge. So this tells us that we will define in the next lecture this thing in terms of potential, and potential is basically the work done on a unit charge. This is the work done on a charge. As long as you are in a conservative field, then the work is independent of the path. The work done is independent of the path. Like gravitational field is conservative field. If I raise it to this point, the potential energy that I have stored in this one is equal to mgh, means it only depends on the height. It doesn't matter you move it to this point this way or any other way, you reach here. So the endpoints does matter, this height does matter, and that's the reason that such field we call is conservative fields. They are conservative. These things will hold there in a conservative field. In integral form, the closed path integral will be equal to zero. Its curl will be equal to zero. And the force associated with that field, that force curl will be equal to zero. That force will also be a diverging force. And the work done on a unit charge in that field will be equal to zero. Similarly, if we are having many charges here at the origin, then we will apply the superposition principle in individually all electric fields will be equal to the curl of individual all fields will be equal to zero, and finally we will have the curl of the net field equal to zero as well. So with this, we are now in a position to define electric potential, and I will tell you what's the need of defining an electric potential when we are having the electric field. So the technical interpretation we will do in the next lecture.